Good morning, dear students. Hope you all are fit and fine. In our last video, we are discussing about internet, which is your chapter number 8. In that chapter, we have learned about the internet, history of internet, the basic requirements for internet connections, then what is multimedia computer, the uses of internet, email, information browsing, e-banking, data sharing. So these are all things we have discussed in our previous video. In today's videos, we are discussing about the socializing, chat and newsgroup. So I guess you all know what is the meaning of socializing. Chat or internet relay chat, IRC. Chat is a real-time communication via keyboard between two or more users over the internet. IRC, internet relay chat, is a protocol for real-time text messaging between interconnected computers. It is mainly used for group discussion in chat rooms called channels. So basically, chat is when you are communicating with your friends online with the help of your mobile device or computer. That thing is called a chat. Sending and receiving message instantly in a real time is called chat. Now the different popular social media sites are Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, WeChat, LinkedIn, Twitter, Skype, Viber, Snapchat. These are the different symbols of the popular social media sites. Now, what is the use of social media sites? So, social networking sites allow users to share ideas, detailed photos and videos, post and to inform others about online or real world activities and even with people in their network. So with the help of social media sites, you can share your thoughts, photos, audio and videos with your friends, which are located at different parts of the world. Here we are discussing about only few social media sites. Apart from this, we are having many more social media sites. Now newsgroup. What is newsgroup? A newsgroup is an online discussion forum accessible through Usenet. Each newsgroup contains discussions about a specific topic indicated in the newsgroup name. You can browse newsgroups and post or replies to topics using a newsreader program. So basically, newsgroup may you are having a discussion about any particular topic. Now see how newsgroup is functioning. Message is created by a newsgroup member and sent to the newsgroup address. In the next step, newsgroup software posts a copy of the message to newsgroup. Now with the help of internet, newsgroup members can go to the newsgroup and read the message. And finally, any newsgroup member can reply to the posting, initiating the entire procedure anew. So this is how newsgroup works. So basically, in newsgroup, you are having a topic in which you are having a discussion. Now, what is the difference between chat rooms and newsgroup? Chat rooms is a location on an internet server that permits users to chat with each other. So, in chat rooms, you can chat with your friends. While in newsgroup is an online area in which users have written discussion about a particular subject. So, in newsgroup, you are having a written discussion about a particular subject. Now, important terms related to internet. There are the different terms which we are using in terms of internet. First is net surfing. What is net surfing? Net surfing, also known as web surfing. Surfing means browsing the internet through web browser. Now what is web browser? Earlier we have discussed about the web browsers. This Opera, Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Internet Explorer, Safari, these are the different web browsers. In a web browsers, browsing of any web page and going from one page to another web page by clicking on any hyperlink is known as net surfing. So moving from one web page to another web page with the help of a web browser is called a net surfing. I hope this thing is clear to you all. Next is your website. What is website? Website is a collection of related web pages at a place on the World Wide Web that contains information about the person, organization, company, education institute, etc. and is usually consist of many web pages joined by hyperlinks is called a website. Now, what is web page? A web page can contain huge information including text, graphics, audio, video and hyperlinks. These hyperlinks are the link to other web pages. Web pages is a document available on the World Wide Web, www. Web pages can be viewed using a web browser. So if you want to view a web browser, you have to use, if you want to see a web page, you have to use web browser. So now the meaning of website and web page is clear to you all. Now we'll take an example. This is the home page of our school website. So now in the home page, you are having this header area. In header area, you are having the name of a school, affiliation number, and affiliated to CBSE Delhi, and the number is given. The school logo is given here, and the different links are given in this blue bar. So what are different links we are having? Home, about us, curriculum, academic, principal desk, TC search, school login, alumni, others, contact us. So these are the different links which we are having in a home page of our school website. Now we'll see the different pages which we are having in our school website. Next is your about us web page. So in about us web page, you are having an introduction about our school and the picture of our school is given. However, the header area is same. In the academic web page, we are having information related to admission and withdrawals. Again, the header is same. In the principal desk web page, we are having a message from principal. In the curriculum web page, we are having a curriculum of primary school. Again, the header area is same, means all the links, home, about us, curriculum, as one, these are all same in all the web pages. Next is your contact us web page. In this web page, you are having the postal address of our school with pin code. You are having office hours, then you are having contact number, then email of our school and the website of our school. So this is given in the contact us web page. Now when we combine all these web pages, we'll get a website. So basically, website is a collection of web pages which are interconnected with each other with the help of a hyperlinks or with the help of a link. So in website, you are having a different web pages which are connected with each other with the help of links, hyperlinks. Now we'll discuss about the important terms related to internet. First is your hyperlink. A connection between one page and another that can be used to move around is a hyperlink. Hyperlinks are used to navigate between pages and website. When text is used as hyperlink, it is usually underlined and appears as a different color. Now, in this text hyperlink, the text hyperlink is hyperlinked. That's why it is blue in color. And when I take my cursor on this link, it will shows a it will change it into a hand cursor. Now see this. Next is internet service providers. Internet service provide internet access employing a range of technologies to connect users to their network. Available technologies have ranged from computers modems with acoustic couplers to telephone lines to television cable, wireless ethernet and fiber optics. In India, ISP services are provided by Reliance, Jio, Airtel, Vodafone, Idea, BSNL. Now, these are the examples of ISPs, Jio, Airtel, BSNL, Vodafone and Idea is combined nowadays. This is a modem. This is fiber optic cable, which is a coaxial cable. This is a telephone line and this is an acoustic coupler. An acoustic coupler is an audio interface device for coupling a computer with audio into or out of a telephone. Search engines. Search engines are programs that search documents for specific keywords where the keywords were found. Today, there are thousands of search engines available on internet. The most popular and well-known search engine is Google. So this is the Google search engine and these are the different search engines: Google, Yahoo, Ask.com, Bing, etc. These are the different search engines. Apart from this, many more search engines are there. Some tips to make search easy. Use quotation mark for exact phrases. Do not use common words and punctuations, drop the suffix, use unique and specific term, use the subsection operator to reduce the search. So these are the different tips for searching your document on internet or on search engine. Email communication through internet. So we have already discussed about this in our previous video. The full form of email is electronic mail. Email has become one of the most common forms of communication. Email communication is not only used instead of letter writing, it has also replaced telephone calls in many social situations and in professional environments. Instead of using pen to write a letter on paper, we are using keyboard to type an email message in an email program on the computer. So this is the traditional method of writing the email, of writing the message, and nowadays we are writing the message with the help of a keyboard on computer or desktop or laptop, and we are sending it to your friends. Email communication through internet. When writing the email is finished and has been addressed to the recipient's email address, press the send button to allow the email message to reach the intended recipient. Now in this picture, which is shown on your screen, Google inbox is there. If you want to write a new message, you have to click on this compose button, this red button. When you click on this compose button, you will get this new message dialog box. In this new message dialog box, you have to write in two fields, you have to write the recipient address. Recipient address means recipient email address means the address where you want to send the email from. In the form field, you have to write your own email ID. Then in subject field, you have to write the subject. Means if you are inviting your friends for your birthday party, you have to write the birthday invitation here. If you are writing a message for leave, you have to write leave message for leave. And in this area, you have to write the text or message. And after writing the text or message, you can just click on this blue button, send button. When you click on the send button, your message will be delivered to the recipient address. So this is how you can create a message and send it to your friends. Thank you. Have a nice day.